A long, long time ago, humans lived in one at one moment in a sense of oneness with nature and the surroundings, and the ego hadn't developed yet. For a long time, probably after the arising of thinking, humans still had a sense of rootedness in being, the natural sense of rootedness in the depths of their being. And gradually over the millennia, they got drawn more and more into the thinking heads mode. And then all their whole sense of identity was no longer rooted in the depths of their being, but in the voice in the head. It is no more than part of the evolutionary process of the species. It's a stage in the evolution. And as we are approaching the next stage in the evolution, we are beginning to see that the ego has completely outlived its usefulness, but it had its usefulness. So from our present perspective, because we are at the end of one evolutionary stage, the ego looks totally absurd once you see what it is and how much havoc it has created. But from a higher perspective, it's part of the evolution of humanity. Without, there could not be no enlightenment or awakening without it, ultimately. In your own life, you can see it, how you had to go through the ignorance in your own life. I mean, not ignorance in the sense of lack of education, but spiritual ignorance, not knowing who you essentially are and making so many mistakes on the basis of the illusory ego identity. And you can see it now, and you had to go through it. And now the next step in the evolution is a return to the pre-egoic state with the added dimension of consciously knowing your connectedness with the One. Whereas before, they were connected with the One without even knowing it. It was a natural state of connectedness. But as we return to the ego, go beyond ego, we now knowingly return to the One consciously, and that's the next stage. And it's all we're only now beginning to see that it is insane, because we're approaching the next stage in human evolution. Before, nobody could see that the ego was insane, although except the very rare, the great masters. The Buddha already said that it's an illusion. Jesus said, deny thyself, which means recognize the unreality of the ego. But not many people understood what they said.